There's a second way to use PShape. This will allow you to create a shape the way you normally would, but then you're able to reuse it just by the shape name. To do so, you have to make a few changes to your program. We already have the PShape planet from where we imported the scalable vector graphic. We're going to also define PShape star, and I've included the int square equals 1. And this is an example of code reusability. I went and grabbed the star from our previous exercise a few weeks ago and just modified it to bring it in here. Now you'll notice that in the size, I have to add an extra definition, P2D, which just means that it's processing 2D graphics. There's also a P3D, which processes 3D graphics, which we won't get into today. I've set the frame rate to 5. The frame rate is a default at 60 frames per second. This is going to make it go slower because these are going to be randomly redrawn several times a second. We might even do it slower to that, to 1, so they change once per second, just so that you can see what's happening. This is my P shape from the external scalable vector graphic. And this is where I begin defining the star P-shape. The first thing I have to do is have star equals create shape. This calls the create shape function. Then everything that I do after that starts with star dot. So we have star dot begin shape, star dot fill. This sets the color of the star. You'll notice I've got a 50% transparent or 50 transparency on this. That goes 0 to 255, so that's fairly transparent. 255 is 100% opacity, 0% 0% opacity. I've set star to no stroke. I've set the vertex points for the star, and I've closed the end shape. Then when I use the star, and I'm doing this here to show you how handy it is if you're going to do looping and you want it to iterate, it's so much cleaner to just call that named star than to redo all of this code like we've done in the past. So I have an for statement that's going to draw 50 stars on the screen every second, because this void draw loops, and every time it loops, it's going to redraw. Since I've set the frame rate to 1, it'll redraw once a second. So here we have that X and Y are going to randomly be working with the for loop to pull in random X and Y locations, X at a range between 0 and the width, Y at a range between 0 and the height, and that's going to draw the star at those XY coordinates. Let's take a look. So it's redrawing. I have this happening very slowly. And you can see that these stars are redrawing. And you can also see how much easier it is to have the star predefined.